Today, we'll be putting a USB 4 SSD enclosure from NewQ through its paces and try to see if it's worth the asking price. This enclosure is based on the ASmedia 2464PD chip, which is supposedly the fastest nvme enclosure solution for M.2 drives. Later in the review, we will also be comparing its performance against a few significantly cheaper enclosures like the Pibox and Ugreen, as well as a pre-built Samsung. In theory, it can yield up to a 40 gigabit per second link, which would translate to real-world transfer speeds of about 3500 megabytes a second or so, which is a significant improvement over the existing USB 3.1 Gen 2 solutions, which typically get capped at around 900 to 950 megabytes a second. The device comes in a nice package and a rather decent silicone sleeve that should help keep it safe while traveling. When you take it out of the enclosure, the first thing that strikes you is how large it is, especially compared to the current generation USB 3 enclosures. It also feels very well built, a fairly solid block of metal with heat dissipation fins, although there's no active cooling. Later in the review, we'll try and see if this proves sufficient for the excess heat that is generated by typical NVMe Gen 4 drives. The rest of the packaging includes a thermal pad for the drive, a seemingly mid-tier quality USB 4 cable, and a manual. Adding a hard drive is easy. The panels are interlocked with bearing locks, and a firm push and pull allows you to detach the two halves. The upper half acts purely as a heat sink, while the lower part houses the electronics. The hard drive holder mechanism is a rubber grommet with slots for all the common M.2 sizes, which includes the 2020-30 drive seen on the Steam Deck, and also the more commonly used 2280 size 2. We're going to use a Crucial P5 Plus Gen 4 2TB NVMe for the tests. The drive itself is rated for speeds up to 6.6 Gbps read and 5 Gbps writes, so that the bottleneck in all the tests remains the enclosure itself and not the physical drive. Installation is straightforward. Simply align the grommet with the drive and push it all the way into the corresponding holder slot. I will, however, say that the rotating grommet as seen on the Ugreen as well as the Pibox is a little more convenient than having to push and pull a grommet out each time, but it's not worth complaining about. Next up is the heatsink. So we take the thermal pad, align it and stick it to the drive, peel off the top sticker, take the heatsink, push it all the way in and lock it into the drive. That's it. And now that the relatively straightforward physical setup is done, it's time to get into the actual test itself. So we plug it into the MacBook and let's get started. Detection is instantaneous. The system information applet confirms that the link speed is 40 gigabits a second. More interestingly, the drive shows up as a PCI Express drive, and this is thanks to the PCIe tunneling that this enclosure uses, as opposed to an external USB drive, which is the case with the other USB 3 enclosures. Moving on to the final results. Copying a almost 20,000 megabyte file onto the drive was blazing fast and took about 6.3 seconds as timed by a stopwatch. Unlike other external drives, this one allows for smart data to be accessed, and we were able to verify that the temperature at the end of the test was a fairly cool 46 degrees Celsius. Just for perspective, this write operation would have taken well over 6 minutes on a traditional USB 2 drive and close to 30 seconds on a USB 3. If you used any form of NVMe enclosures before, you'll surely notice the exceptionally higher sequential read and write speeds. The same trend continues in the random 4K reads as well. Plotting out the relative performance of the Ugreen Pibox and Samsung T7, you can clearly see the significant improvements that you get via USB 4 for most common benchmarks. Similarly, on the right side, you see a huge performance jump with USB 4 as against the USB 3 enclosures that we have. The only exception to this would be the random 4K operations with a queue depth of 1. Though if you were to ask me, I think it's more of a theoretical test, which has very limited if no meaning these days. More importantly, the ASmedia enclosure comes quite close to matching the performance of the internal Apple SSDs on the M.1 Pro and the M.3 Pro. But except for the sequential tests with a queue depth of 8, but perhaps that's expecting a bit too much. But all in all, you've got to say, that external enclosures have come a long way over the last few years. From the large and rather slow 3.5-inch enclosures at 30 megabytes a second to tiny little dongle-sized doohickeys that can do over 3,000. The big question though is that, is it worth paying 5 times the price of a regular USB-C enclosure? Probably not for most users, and very likely not if you want to use it purely as a portable drive. But if you have a Mac Mini or a MacBook or a Surface Pro or any other device with a fixed drive and want to extend the storage to a near natural extension of your internal option, these new enclosures may just be what you need. Thank you for watching, and do feel free to leave any questions you may have in the comments below.